Sometimes installing an Expo package or third-party library isn't enough to extend your app's capabilities. In those cases, you might need to write custom native code to access platform-specific APIs or leverage native Android and iOS dependencies. Fortunately, Expo provides robust support for these through Expo modules. In today's video, we'll create a native module that stores the user's preferred app theme. We'll use Swift for iOS and Kotlin for Android, covering topics like emitting events, responding to native changes on the JavaScript side, persisting theme preferences, and more. So let's dive in. To get started, the first thing that I'll do is create a new Expo module by running the command npx create Expo module and then provide the name of the module. In this case, I'll prefix it with Expo and then the name, which is settings. So let's go ahead and hit enter. I won't be publishing this module, so I'll just go ahead and select the defaults. For the native module, I just leave Expo settings as well. Would you like to describe the module? My new module? Of course, you can customize this as you want. So let's go ahead and select the defaults, as well as the author, email address, and the URL, everything. Let's just hit enter, and this will install the module dependencies. All right, after a moment, our project is ready, and we can start developing the Expo module. So let's go ahead and CD into the Expo settings, and now I'll open this in VS Code. Okay, so I have here the project open in VS Code, and let's just explore a little bit of what we have in here. We have an Android folder, an iOS folder, as well as an example folder. This example folder contains an example app that is going to be running our native module so that we can test it. And then we also have the source. The source will contain the types and the export of the module that then we can import in the example app so that we can test it. Now let's start by cleaning this a bit. Let's go into the iOS folder, and we won't be creating a view, so I'll go ahead and delete this file. Let's go to the Android inside the source Java. I will delete as well this view file. And in the source folder, I will remove the Expo setting types, and I'll remove as well this web TS and as well as this web view. So we are not going to be building this for web, but if you want, you can actually build the web part using local storage. Now, the next thing that I'll do is go to my Expo settings module. I'll just go ahead and select everything and delete some of the majority of it, and just leave the name and this function, which is getting the theme. Now, this is so that we can easily understand what's going on. Let's do the same for Android. So let's scroll a bit up and let's go to the Expo settings module Kotlin file. I will select everything and then just replace so that we have this clean module and everyone can understand what's going on in here. Now let's go to the index.tsx. And of course, we deleted some of these files. I'll go ahead and select everything. And this is how your file should look like. We only have a function that it's called getTheme. And we are grabbing this function from the module, Expo settings module. So let's go ahead and hit save. Okay, so now our module is clean and we are ready to start developing. So what I'll do next is just go to the example app. And then we have this app.tsx, which is the entry point. And let's go ahead and replace everything to render this getTheme that we are grabbing from the settings module, okay? And by the way, this Expo settings, it's coming from our index source in here. Okay, so we don't need to install this dependency. It's already accessible in our example app. Let's start the example app. So in my root folder, I'll run npm run build. This command will actually start the TypeScript compiler, and it will help us to find errors. Like in this case, we are trying to access the view that we deleted, and this is happening in the Expo settings view. And by the way, we won't be needing this view, so let's go ahead and delete it. And now we don't have any errors. Okay, so let's just leave this running as it is, and I'll open a new terminal. Let's cd into the example project, and from here we can run the app. So I'll say npx expo run iOS and hit enter. This will create a development build and run it in my simulator. Okay, the development build is ready, and now it's installing it in my iPhone 15 Pro. And there we have it. So the theme is system. At this point, we have an Expo module working. Now let's run this app on Android. I'll go back to my terminal, and in this case, I'll create a new terminal by pressing this plus sign, and then go back to the example folder. And from here, we can say npx expo run, in this case, Android, and hit enter. Okay, and the Android build is ready. Finally, as you can see here, it's loading and we have the same result as in iOS. Theme, it's equal to system, which if you remember, we technically hard coded. And then let's just quickly go to the Expo settings module Kotlin. And at this point, as you can see here, we are creating a function called getTheme, but so far it's just returning a hard coded string that says system. It's the one that we are seeing in the app. And if we go to the Expo settings module, we're doing the same thing. In this case, we are typing the return value as a string, as you can see there. And it's the same thing, system. Now I want to start getting and setting the theme instead of hard coding it. And we could do that here in VS Code, but a pro tip to get syntax highlight is using Xcode when developing with Swift and Android Studio when developing with Kotlin. So let's start with iOS. Let's open this module in Xcode. To do that, I'll open the terminal again, create a new terminal since my two terminals are running there. And I'll go to the example app. And from here, I can open the iOS folder using Xcode. And by the way, let me show you the iOS folder that I'm talking about. This iOS folder, I want to open it on Xcode, and we can do that by saying xed and then passing the name of the folder that we want to open. So if I press enter now, Xcode will open the iOS folder, which contains the native code of my example app. And as you can see, here we have the Xcode project. Okay, so now I have my app open in Xcode. And the next thing that I'll do is click on the pods and expand the pods on the left side, select development pods, and here you'll find the Expo settings module that we are working on. And if you expand this one, you'll find the Expo settings module. So I'll double click on this one, and this is the module that we are working on. Now, the only difference is that we are going to be getting syntax highlight every time we type something. So for example, if I say string, you can see that I get this dropdown from Xcode that is telling me, okay, you're trying to type a string. So I'll go ahead and hit enter and it will give me the string. We won't get that in VS Code. That's why we need to use Xcode for iOS and Android Studio for Android. Okay, so let's start by transforming this function. In this case, I'll name this one to setTheme. This is a function that is going to get a theme. So we can say theme, and this is going to be of type string, and it's going to return, in this case, a void. Now, as I was mentioning before, we can use the user defaults interface, and I can say standard set, and then we can pass a theme. And for key, let's use theme. Now, this is the setter. Let's create a getter, which is going to be very similar. Now, the only thing that I'll change instead is going to be get. Now, when we are getting the theme, we won't be passing anything, and this will return something, which is a string, and we can still use the user defaults standard. In this case, I'll say string, and we need to look for the key. The key is going to be theme. Now, as I was mentioning before, because we are using Xcode, now I get this really nice error that is telling me this is a value optional and it could be null, right? So we can add an extra validation here that if we don't find anything, I just return the system string. Now the error goes away and this is how it looks. And now let's go back. As you can see here, I have my Expo settings module in Swift with the new functions that I created, the set and get. Now let's go to the index, and instead of getting the theme, since I deleted that function, I will replace this for the get theme and set theme with their respective types. So the get theme is going to return a string, and the set theme is not going to return anything since it's going to set the theme, right? So it's taking the theme as a parameter. So let's go ahead and hit save. We can now use the settings API in our example app. So let's go to the app TSX. We are importing all as settings from Expo settings, and inside the app, we can say const theme equal to, and I'll say settings dot, and we have the get theme and set theme. So I'll use my get theme. And then in here, I'll just replace these settings, get theme, and just put the theme directly. The same way we're using the get theme, at this point, we can use the set theme. So let's create a button using the React Native button, and I'll give it a title, change theme. And whenever we press this button, we call the onPress property, and we get the set theme passing the string as property, in this case dark. Now, instead of hard coding this to dark, let's try to toggle this so we can create a variable up here called next theme, and this is going to be changing depending on the current theme. So if it's dark, I want to set it to light, otherwise to dark. So let's go ahead and grab this variable and pass it here like this. Now let's run the app to see if this is working. Because I changed native code, I need to rebuild the application. There's a couple ways to do this. We can just go ahead and create a new terminal and say npx expo run iOS again, or we can go to Xcode and select my device from the dropdown and hit play on the top left. Okay, so the build is ready. And as you can see, when I press the change theme button, nothing happens. That is because we are never fetching the new theme value and re-rendering the application. That makes sense. But actually, when we press a theme, something is happening, and we can prove that by opening the console. But I can add a print that says theme set to and the new value. Okay, so let's hit save and rebuild the app. Okay, and the app is running. Let me make the terminal a bit bigger. All right, and it's running. Now, every time that I press the change theme, although nothing is happening, you can see that we are setting the theme to light because right now it's dark. And by the way, when I restart the application, you can see that this is actually changing, but it's not updating the UI. So let's go ahead and reload. Now this time it's light. And if I press change theme, it's going to be set to dark, as you can see in the native side. And if I reload, it's going to be dark. So this is working great, but now let's see how we can emit change events for the theme value so that we can ensure that developers using our API can react to changes in the theme value by emitting a change event when the value changes. For this, we can use the event emitter API to subscribe to events in JavaScript. So after the name, I will create an event like this, and the name is going to be on change theme. Oops, and I'm missing an S here. Events. And the next thing that I'll do is instead of printing the next theme, I want to send an event. So I can say send event and then passing the name on change theme, and let's pass the value. So this is going to be inside an array like this, and the value is going to be theme passing the theme value like so. Okay, so now we need to go back to VS Code. Let me hide the terminal. I'll go to my index, and above of these two functions, I will declare the event emitter, and we can import this from the Expo Modules core. We can import as well the subscription, and let's hit save. So what we're doing here is just defining the theme change event. This is a type of theme, type of string. And then we're also defining this function at theme listener. So the user of this API that we are developing can use this listener to get the events every time that we change the theme. This is going to be of type subscription, and we are using the emitter, then adding a listener, passing the type on this generic, and passing the name of the event. In this case, when we change the theme, passing the listener as a second parameter. So this is the add theme listener. Then we can use this in our application. So let's go to the app example, and to set this event listener, I will use a use effect from React. Let me just go ahead and import this directly like so. And then I'll use use state to store the theme. So now instead of having this static value in here, I can just replace this to use use state from React, passing the type, which is going to be a string. And then we can initialize this using our native module as well. So I'm calling here the get theme, and this will get the default theme. Now, every time that the theme changes, we're using the add theme listener, and this is going to return a callback function with a new value of the theme, and we grab this new value and set the theme. Now, because we are using use state, this will trigger a re-render, which effectively it's going to update this theme. Okay, so let's go ahead and hit save, and let's go to the application. We need to rebuild because we changed the native code. So let's go ahead and play. Okay, and as you can see there, the theme is dark. Now let's change it to light. And every time that I press the change theme, it's working great. Now from here, the users of our API can use this theme to validate maybe the styles. So for example, we can create a background color that is using the theme and it's changing the theme. And we need to do the same for the text. So we can say style and change the color based on the theme. Okay, so let's go ahead and see the app. Let me change the theme. And now it's dark. And yeah, we can keep toggling using our Expo module. That's very exciting. Now let's see how we can achieve the same functionality using Android. So to develop the module on Android, we can follow the same approach. Now in this case, I want to open Android Studio. So for Android, we're gonna do the same. I have here Android Studio open. So I'll click on the open folder and I'll navigate to my Expo settings folder and then select the example app. Select the Android folder and click on open. Okay, and this is my example app. Now let's wait a moment until the gradle build is finished. Okay, and after a moment, the project is ready, so I can close this window. And on the left, you'll see that we have the Expo settings module that we are developing. And if you click on the Kotlin plus Java, you'll find the Expo settings module. Okay, now we are ready to start developing our Android module. I'll go ahead and close the sidebar. So the idea is going to be the same one. And because the API is very similar in both platforms, we can simply create the same thing, right? So in this case, we're going to be using the get preferences. And to use these get preferences, we need to import up here the shared preferences. Now down here, I will create this get preferences function, which is grabbing the context using the get shared preferences that I'm importing here. And then it's just returning the string. Now this context can't be found. So let's go ahead and import it up here. Okay, and now let's quickly run into these two functions. We have the set theme, which in this case, it's using the get preferences function to edit the preference and set the theme based on the parameter that we are passing. We also have the get theme, which is returning the current theme by using the get preferences, get string, passing the key theme. And then the value default is going to be system as well. Of course, the syntax is the only thing that is changing because at this point we're using Kotlin and for iOS, we were using Swift, but it's very similar. Okay, now let's see how we can emit events. For that, we're gonna be using bundle because the payloads that we're gonna be passing to the JavaScript side are represented as bundles. So the same thing that we did with iOS, after the name, I will define from events the unchanged theme. And once we set the theme, I will send an event. So from here, we are using the Expo settings module, send event, and we are passing the name of the event that we are sending in this change, in this case, the unchanged theme. And then we are using the bundle of to send the payload. In this case, it's going to be the theme mapped to the new theme. And look at this. This is a cool warning that, Android Studio, it's asking me to consider using apply instead of commit because this writes its data to the persistent storage immediately. So let's go ahead and try that. Okay, so I'll go ahead and hit save. From the dropdown, I'll select my Pixel 3, which is this one right here, and just press the rerun. At this point, I don't need to change anything on VS Code because the JavaScript is going to be the same. The only difference is going to be the specific native code implementation. And the app is running. Cool. So let's try this out. Change theme. And as you can see, it's working. The exact same functionality. How exciting is that? Congratulations, you have created your first Expo module. Alrighty guys, that's it for today's video on creating an Expo module. I hope you found this helpful and that you are excited to start building your own custom modules. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notifications bell so you don't miss any future content. For next steps, try experimenting with different native functionalities or explore how to optimize the module that we built today. Feel free to share any questions or suggestions in the comment below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.